and wanted to give that to others. So three very different people, three messages with that. They all come from different walks of life and at different time eras. And the messages are messages of love, mercy, and peace. And Therese, in a letter that was written by John Paul II, said that I understood that the church had a heart, and this heart was aflame with love. So the church has a heart, and this heart is aflame with love. So I'm going to step back for a minute. We're going to go kind of step away from this conversation, and we're going to talk about our physical bodies and our, starting with our heart, okay? And talk about the lymphatic system for just a few minutes. Okay, and if you will look, I'm going to write this down because it'll be a little bit easier. Okay. Can everybody see this right here? Becky, you might even stand up where you can get a better look at it with that. So our hearts are pumping blood throughout our entire bodies, right? And this blood is going through arteries. Okay, and the blood consists of red blood cells, white blood cells, and plasma. Okay, the red blood cells are carrying our oxygen, which we need for life, and our iron. The white blood cells are our immune-fighting cells. They're the ones that protect us from infections. And the plasma is the water part of our blood. And in that water is nutrients that we need to sustain life and proteins. So all of this is going to the tissue spaces. Okay, and when that blood gets to the different cells throughout our entire body, then the water goes out into that tissue space as an H2O. So it's taking that nutrition out to the different cells of our body. Okay? And then what the cells are doing is the cells are picking up that water and they're giving off their waste product, what it doesn't need anymore. Okay, does that make sense to everybody? Okay. And then what happens is that the blood continues back up to the heart by way of veins. And there's a secondary system, and that system is what, do you know? The lymphatic system. And then the lymphatic system, it's taking in that water and it's taking in the waste products. It'll also take in proteins, okay? So when we think about lymphedema, we think of it as a protein-rich fluid. So it's also taking in proteins that are too large to get back into our venous system, our vein system. And so it collects all this up and it transports it to regional lymph nodes. And it might go through multiple lymph nodes on the way to the heart. And the job of the lymph node is to filter this fluid, to filter it. They're like little water filters. Okay, filter the lymph. And so it's taking those particles and it's breaking it down into smaller pieces so it's easier for our bodies to eliminate it. So that by the time that this water gets back up to the heart and drains back into our venous system, it's now in a clean and a more purified state, so to speak. It'll also, those lymph nodes will help to fight any kind of infection that there might be. Okay, good, thank you. So the lymphatic system is a one-way system with a direction of flow towards the heart. And on its way, it's going to go through lymph nodes that are filtering that lymph. And it's also helping to fight against infection and disease. Okay, so lymphedema is defined as a backup of lymph fluid, right? So if you're having a problem, in Maureen's case, it was what we would call a primary lymphedema, okay? The lymph system itself was not properly developed, so a kind of a primary lymphedema, and as a result of that, I might even just say almost like a childhood. It can occur later in life, but it's kind of a, something that is where it's just not developed by itself. So it may have trouble picking up that fluid and transporting it. We can also have secondary. Therese was a cancer related with her mother, or in the case of Ignatius, it was traumatic, okay, with that. When you have that backup, then that fluid is not going to properly filter the way that it needs to get filtered. Waste products and proteins build up in the tissue spaces, and the tissue starts to become fibrotic or hardened. Everyone familiar with that? And there can be an increased risk of skin infections. So now here's where, these are my reflections now, you know, because I'm thinking to myself, you know, why would God choose somebody that had lymphedema? It's such a rare condition to have. Why did he pick that, you know, as the reason why to, you know, to have this miracle if it indeed happened? You know, why pick this man that had the swelling in his legs, or this nun that had a mother with breast cancer? Why? So I'm thinking about these things, and I'm thinking that if there is a faith condition, if somebody in childhood doesn't learn much about faith, or someone has something that maybe causes them to lose their faith, maybe an addiction or something like that, or maybe there was a trauma that happened that can affect their faith, then they may also have some kind of decrease or delayed spiritual flow, that the spirit cannot move through them. And if this happens, they may also have a lack of spiritual filtering, that ability to choose what is good and right and get rid of what is not so healthy or good for us from a spiritual point of view. There can be a buildup of spiritual toxins, just like our body can get built up with toxins, and spiritual hardening. You know, maybe they start to become hardened by whatever it is that is happening with them. And lastly, just spiritually unwell, that they're just, generally they're not as healthy from a spiritual point of view. So the treatment for lymphedema, which many of you probably know fairly well, is what? Good skin care. Manual lymphatic drainage to help facilitate lymph flow. Exercises. And compression garments. Compression bandaging and compression garments. I have a few here. So from a faith point of view, if there's a faith condition that's an issue, then what can be done about that? And I say that there can be spiritual care. And these are the daily activities that a person might do to help just keep themselves clean, spiritually clean, spiritually moisturized or nourished, spiritually protected. What do you do to keep yourself spiritually protected? You know, that you don't get the kind of the cuts, the scratches, the injuries that might happen from a spiritual standpoint. Spiritual therapy, kind of like manual lymphatic drainage. What do you do to facilitate lymph flow when maybe it's, or excuse me, spiritual flow when it's not moving well, or that there's a hardened area? Maybe you need to, you know, do something to kind of help with a problem that either you're having or, you know, you might suggest that to somebody else. Can you see our audio? Okay. With that. How do you, what can you do to help kind of stimulate spiritual flow? Spiritual exercises. And Ignatius says that just like walking, running, exercising, lifting weights, stretching, those are good things to help with our physical bodies, that you can do something similar for your spiritual life, to build up your spiritual strength, to build up your spiritual endurance, to build your flexibility so that maybe you can have a better tolerance for people that are a little bit different than yourself in some way. And lastly, spiritual attire. What do you put on every day that helps you, you know, and maybe helps other people? You know, putting on love, faith, hope, generosity, kindness, those kind of things. You know, just to kind of help from a spiritual point of view. Maybe there's like the armor of God that you might put on, you know, spiritually to protect yourself. And finally, related to the, you know, the lymphedema, when someone comes in and they're telling me that they're a little bit swollen, you know, that something's going on, the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to say, okay, so what have you been doing, you know, over the last 24 to 46, 48 hours? You know, have you been wearing your compression and doing your manual drainage or your exercises? Let's look at the activities that you've been doing. You know, maybe there's some activities that have caused you to have an increase in your swelling. Maybe there's some activities that have been actually helpful, like rest and elevation are helpful from a swelling point of view. And in a similar way, Ignatius gives what he calls the examine. And I have something that towards the end of our talk that goes over an example of an examine so that you can see it. But basically, it's each day, you know, asking yourself some questions to see how are you doing in your faith life. You know, and you just kind of think about, you know, how did my morning go, and, you know, what went well and what didn't go well. You know, and maybe kind of think about it. And just know there's some subtleties to it. Because like Ignatius, when he was thinking about the ladies, he liked it. You know, it felt good to him, but it wasn't until later that it wasn't so good. And from a lymphedema point of view, you might do the whole house, clean it, and no problem, but the next day you're swollen. So sometimes it's not right away that you notice that there's a problem, but down the road that you notice a problem, and that you can start to discern that. In 2000, John Paul II said of Thérèse that the way that Thérèse took to reach her ideal of life is a way that is within each person's reach. It's the little way, a path of trust and total self-abandonment to the Lord's grace. A path of trust and total self-abandonment to the Lord's grace. And the words to Faustina from Jesus is that I am love and mercy itself. The soul that trusts in my mercy is most fortunate because I myself take care of it. And so both of them spoke about trust, you know, the importance of trust. And in the examine, and this I took it from Ignatius and I just applied it with some of the things that we've talked about today. First, you want to become aware of God's presence, you know, in the moment, and given thanks for the gifts in my life. So, you know, whatever those gifts are of a particular day, you know, thanking Him for the clothes that you're wearing, the fact that you have a roof over your head, and it's relatively warm in here, not totally warm, but, you know, we're not out in the cold, that kind of thing. We've got food on our table, that type of thing. And then maybe even more specific, you know, that, you know, you had a really nice time talking to a friend today. You know, and you kind of start to remember, or maybe someone smiled at you in the store and it just, you felt good about it, that kind of thing. And thank God. And then ask for the grace to know yourself better. The thoughts are that as we get to know ourselves, we get to know God.